And there is our championship trophy up for grabs. 5 points separate Pastrana, Scott Speed, and then Timmy Hansen. You can see him back there waiting in the wings. What's that, do again, that math thing again? What's it called? 50, is that 50, 16 points?
It's close. It's 16 points here between Timmy Hansen and Travis Pastrana. So he needs three cars in between. If Timmy were to win, he needs three cars between him and Travis and two cars between him and Speed. Travis must finish behind Scott Speed. If he finishes equal on points, he would win on countback. There's a bit of math, but it's mostly just sending awesomeness down to turn one, getting this job done after five brilliant rounds.
All right, so with more dirt on literally this dirty track, I throw it down to Will, who's down on the Subaru pits. Will?
Guys, the atmosphere down here, I'm just going to let you take a look at Team Subaru right now and have a look on their faces. They just told me, you know, they're normally nervous, but they are more nervous than they have ever been. We know there's a lot on the line here. We've got driver championship, of course, the team championship as well. So right now, these guys are just ready for what is going to be an absolutely huge race for them. And we're going to find out soon enough.
Bit of a smirk there for Travis Pastrana. He's kind of not the open face, but that stage rally helmet with that comms there. Scott Speed vying for the kind of full face. And there's, again, Timmy Hansen. So those three gentlemen, look at that. So where do you think that posture comes from?
I love the fact Timmy's clocked the fact that he's on. You know, he's just chilling. He's a thumbs up. He's ready to go. He's on the front row. Don't count him out. Don't count him out. We are getting ourselves ready to go.
And here is our grid. Scott Speed and Timmy Hansen on the front line. Pastrana behind his Subaru teammate and Kevin Hansen behind his brother. Third row, Steve Arpin, the Canadian Cowboy, Robin Larsson, and bring up the rear, Chase Elliott and Tanner Foust. Let's send it, Andrew Coley and Nitro Rallycross Supercars here.
This is it then, six laps to decide the first ever Nitro Rallycross Champion. Speed, Pastrana or Timmy, great start on the front row to Scott Speed. Timmy Hansen gets moved across, Travis Pastrana gets a huge
win.
Oh, over the curbs on the inside line, Pastrana goes up the inside of his teammate. Timmy Hansen leads, Scott Speed goes around the outside and goes straight to the Joker lap. That was a really aggressive move there from Travis Pastrana in turn one. He cut across the curbs on the inside line. I mean, yeah.
Wow, these are really expensive pinatas. And guess what? Scott Speed slowing down as he went through the Joker lap. He is scrubbing a lot of speed. I definitely want to roll that back and see what happened. This is really interesting as far as what transpired there. Timmy Hansen now in front, Pastrana in second, Arpin in third.
So Scott Speed still going right now. Has he taken damage in that hit? Look how low the sun is. That's really going to affect the drivers as they come back through the wooded section. We're on lap 1 of 6. We had drama in the very first corner. Timmy leads from Pastrana. At the moment, as it stands, Travis Pastrana would win the Nitro Rallycross Championship, but that first corner, was he two wheels on?
What happened?
He went for it, dude. That's right. Kevin squeezed him on the outside. Kevin did what we thought he would do. Supported his brother. Squeezes Travis. Travis goes deep into turn one. Was the move on him? And we'll see. We'll have to take a look back. It happened so quickly. I wasn't expecting it so soon.
No, not at all. Chase Elliott bringing up the rear in that Go Nitro car powered by ZipRecruiter. Chase Elliott, NASCAR champion of 2020. Not part of the equation, but definitely part of the conversation. Here we go. Timmy Hansen goes for the jump. And Pastrana, and they're saying there's no infraction. They said that's a racing incident. And there we go. Double thumbs up for us, as well as, I got to assume, the drivers as well.
Well, this is a race then for the championship between Hansen and Pastrana. Pastrana can afford to stay where he is. So much support for him here as he backs the big Subaru into the double right-handers. He's chasing Timmy Hansen, we know, is a real pavement expert. Travis doesn't need to win. He'll know that. It'd be nice to win. Always good to win a championship with a win. But he's just got a job to do. Keep that Subaru facing in the direction it needs to.
Because we talked about it on the front end right before. Look at the Yokohama tire marks in the side of Pastrana. 16 points separate our current leader, Timmy Hansen, and Pastrana as far as this race goes. But overall championship, again, 16 points. If this race right now, checkered flag, Pastrana wins the championship. But there are 4 laps left to go.
But it also nudges Speed down to P3, Jared, because Timmy is far enough up the road here that if he finishes in front of Travis where he is, he'll edge Scott in terms of the points. Scott Speed is stuck down behind
Pastrana
Kevin
with his best lap, 106.68.
Yeah, so Pastrana's on a big, big push. And I'll say Kevin at the minute is in front of Scott Speed, so Scott's got to try and find a way past. It's kind of irrelevant. The race is just between the two out front. Timmy Hansen's gone Joker. And Pastrana then, so Hansen now 6.1 back. Pastrana, that's the gap we've got to watch.
Also, keep in mind, I brought this up in the NASCAR, in the next car vehicles. This is the longest track we've seen, just over a mile, and the most pavement as well.
I'm interested why they've joked Timmy when they joked him. So they've joked him and put him in behind with Kevin Hansen almost as his rear gunner, but I'm interested why they would joker him so soon. I would have expected them to wait until longer. So Pastrana leads on the road at the moment. The Hansens have pulled a bit of a move. They're very tactical. They'll know why they've done it and what they've done. So Kevin's right there for him, but Travis wasn't exactly hassling him.
So this is interesting too. Look at this, Pastrana has not taken the joker lap. Timmy has taken it 5.3 seconds, 5.1 seconds.
Kevin Hansen for the danger man. He's only 6.5 off the back. So Kevin Hansen's almost within shouting distance again in front of Pastrana. But they need three cars between Timmy and Pastrana to take the title away from Travis. So Travis is far enough up the road that if they want to edge him on the points, they've got to have three cars in between them. They'll be frantically working it out like we are. Pastrana's just hanging on out there.
And here we are riding with Scott Speed, who's back in P5, 7.2 seconds off the leader. But keep in mind, again, Pastrana has not taken that joker lap, neither him or Arpin. Look at Hansen, 4.8 seconds behind Pastrana. That he could close the gap there with Pastrana taking that joker lap, and he could get the lead.
Arpin's going to come back in, isn't he, into position with these guys. Yeah, Kevin could get it. Well, Timmy's in front of Kevin, 4.8. I'm trying to. Timmy's going to come out clearly back in front of Travis here. Travis comes back out onto the front straight. Arpin is only 3.1 behind. Arpin plus six is going to drop out behind the back of that battle, Jared. He's going to be in behind speed, so he's kind of relevant too. It's really about where Travis finishes compared to Timmy. And I don't think there's going to be enough cars in between. The best lap, Timmy Hansen. He's pushing so hard.
Yeah, he said it earlier today. He says, I have nothing to lose. I'm having a great season. He's 16 points behind. He knows what he needs to do, but he's got a smile on his face. And I really think that at the end of this race, it's a big celebration for the sport of rallycross, especially here in the States. I mean, this is Nitro Rallycross is a brainchild, and Travis never thought there would be a legitimate series. This is as legitimate as it gets. Major manufacturers, star talent from all across the globe, and Travis Pastrana is leading it, and here we go, Coley. So, again, we are we're on the fifth lap of sixth. This is the longest we've seen of Nitro Rallycross this year. Again, being the longest, the most pavement, a lot of abuse.
Scott Speed and Timmy Hansen now are only a couple of cars apart, and so I think it's going to be close on. I think he needs extra cars in between, whether or not he can take that second place in the standings. But Pastrana on the dirt again. There's Arpin back up and over the top. Down onto the front straight again for Travis Pastrana.
I mean, 6.2 seconds is kind of the ideal. 4.7, that's too tight, man. Timmy Hansen is going to take the lead here. Travis goes for the Yokohama Tire Joker lap. Can he hold on to the lead? Or is Timmy Hansen going to get it back? Arpin goes for the Joker lap. Pastrana needs to be the quickest he's ever been through the Joker lap. And no, Timmy Hansen,
Pastrana's
Speed.
He's behind Scott. He's going to be behind Scott Speed. Is he going to try and go around him? He can follow him to the line, remember. If he follows him to the line, there's only two cars in between. They needed one more car. The Hansens needed one more car in between for the points. So Travis Pastrana now can follow Scott Speed to the line. And if he's right behind him, they'll finish equal on points, but Travis will win on countback for number of wins.
That's right, because Travis Pastrana most recently won in Glen Helen. He won just before that, back-to-back wins, Arizona and California. Scott Speed won back at ERX, so it defaults back to how many wins. And Pastrana has more wins. Timmy Hansen, Kevin Hansen, Speed, Pastrana. That's your 1-4.
Masterful tactics from the Hansen squad. They were the first two winners of the first ever Nitro Rallycross events in 18 and 19. But this is the first time we've had a Nitro Rallycross championship. The sun sets here in Florida on a brilliant season. Hansen from Hansen for the win. But Travis Pastrana is going to follow his teammate Speed over the line. And he is your 2021 Nitro Rallycross champion.
I would be too. I got bumped. It bumped me sideways. I couldn't get on the brakes. I really messed him up. I feel horrible, man.
And there it is. You can see Travis Pastrana talking so quickly, already elaborating on this race. He's not thinking about championship, but overall, unofficially, as you say, Pastrana over Speed. And there it is. So defaulting to the victories, as you called it, Andrew, Pastrana gets the win over that, and he gets 1 point over Timmy. So look at that. The shaping and the changing of the guards. Timmy Hansen, a smile says it all. Getting that victory is a win in itself.
Of course it is. He lost the world championship last week on countback, and he comes here to arguably, you know, the fastest growing, biggest rallycross championship in the world. Takes a win against the best rallycross drivers over here, and that will mean the world to Timmy. That's a great way for him to sign off on, potentially on his internal combustion career in rallycross. He takes a victory here.
Oh, that's great.
And Pastrana, turn one, look. Jared, you know, championships, they're often contentious. There's often that moment that decides it. That there's going to be turn one. You wait to, you know, the comments and everybody getting involved. But Travis did a brilliant job. He got squeezed so hard in the first corner by Kevin. Let's see.
That was wild. I did not expect that. Maybe we did expect it. But there he is, Travis Pastrana getting outside of his vehicle. Scott Speed, and there they are. Scott Speed, the 41, taking off his gloves. And Scott hyped because Subaru wins the championship.
This is actually the first ever Drivers' Championship of Subaru Motorsport USA as well. Travis Pastrana. I think his teammate Scott Speed will hold on to P2 in the standings. Little chat between them.
Trying to eavesdrop on their conversation. Andrew, there it is, and there it is.
Travis Pastrana, yeah, finishes equal on points with his teammate Scott Speed. It goes on count back, and Pastrana, with more wins than Speed, takes the title.
I got smashed from Kevin.
A lot of discussion already. You know, it's like Senna Prost. It's like Backer and Hansen. And now, you know, teammates, it's even more like Senna Prost. You know, Pastrana and Speed. Little hug there from Timmy taking the win from Travis, who's taken the championship.
So again, they tied in points 219, but it defaults back to wins. And with the win, look, he says not just yet.
Okay, so.
I don't know, what's the tension here?
Turn one. Travis is wondering whether or not there's going to be a decision on turn one. I don't think he wants to take the trophy, but they're going to give it to him anyway.
There's some tension down here.
There is.
And now Travis takes over the trophy, and there it is. Travis, hold it up high. You are 2021 Nitro Rallycross Supercar Champion. Pilot of the Subaru, and that means 1 and 2. Pastrana first overall, Scott Speed, and Timmy Hansen in third as he stands atop his trusty steed. Coley, still feeling that turn one.
Pastrana, what a brilliant year for him. He won the ARA Rally Championship. Now he wins Nitro Rallycross as well. It's the perfect season. He's come on so much as a rallycross driver this year. You've got to be aggressive. You've got to go for it. Yeah, he went. I think the steering wheel says you've got to want it. He wanted it. He went for it. He got it.
All right, let's throw it down to Will, who is down there. Congratulations to Travis Pastrana. Will, get on in there. Talk to our champion.
Travis. Are you okay? Congratulations. Hang on, more hugs going on here. Give us just 1 second. Travis, congratulations first and foremost. Unbelievable, your first rallycross title. We know how much this means to you. But that did not go how the playbook had it written there. That was not seamless at all. At any point did you think you got this done?
It all came down that it's been a tough year for the Hansens and for just decision making in general. We got smashed by Kevin coming in the first, which I would have done the same. And when he hit me, once you break loose on pay, I feel really bad for Scott coming in there. He mentored me all year. He did everything all year. He was the fastest at the race this year. I don't know if it's official. That's awesome. I hate to have something go down like that. But I just want to say thank you to Subaru. Thank you to the fans. Thank you guys for coming out. This has been an absolutely amazing year. This was the most regular kind of track, and we definitely had the most carnage for sure. It was very difficult to pass on there, but I tell you, I love the firm. You guys have been awesome. Everyone down here in Florida, but just huge thanks to Yokohama, KMC, and Subaru, and huge thanks to Scott Speed for honestly getting me to even be close to this championship. And I know there's going to be some interesting things after this, but hopefully when everyone sees the footage, it is what it is. But anyway, I just want to say thank you. Just to be in the hunt for this championship, I was the fourth fastest all weekend, and we ended up fourth in the race. But I tell you, the Subaru crew did amazing, and we got that win in the heat race when we needed it. And I just want to thank everyone. It's been an amazing, amazing ride this year.
Thank you so much, Travis, and thank you to you and the whole team. It's been absolutely fantastic to watching you race all season long. We're going to go have a chat with Scott now. We'll just head down.
Bastards. Holy smokes.
Scott, does...
Is that... Oh, that's cold.
Have some champagne.
Well, Will's going to make her way down and try and have a catch up with Scott, and we'll hear the other side of it. Travis is obviously going to just, you know, that's what happens when championships go down, isn't it?
You know, there can be only one overall winner, and it's accumulation of a season. It might have come down to this one race, but it's the four previous races. It's the bracket battles. It's the victory. It's a culmination. It's not just this one turn to rule them all.
They finished
it's all the whole season. Travis won the first two or the previous two rounds. Scott won round two. So all this, guess what? Travis Pastrana is your champion.
They were equal on points, as you said, every single point. If one of them had missed one point in the qualifying stages at one event, it would have gone the other way. So, yeah, you're right. It's the accumulation of an entire season. The season's full of stuff. Things happen.
I know still for Scott. It's true, Scott.
No, it does. Can we get another interview over here? I'm still hot.
Okay, well, there you go. A lot of discussion carrying on.
Yeah, there's just some tension here in regards to what's going on. Big P, thank you for waving the flags this season. Yeah, he's down there, that gentleman next to Travis. He's the one who waves the flags. Here, let's take a look. Here we are in car.
Right, so Kevin has squeezed Scott, Travis super hard. Wow, that's close.
He went up on two wheels.
Yeah, he did. He's still got two wheels on the tarmac. That's the difference between Timmy yesterday when he didn't have any wheels on. So watch it from the back. Kevin's moved across instantly. I expected that, Jared, because Travis was the one who had the most points advantage over Timmy. Therefore, Kevin has to try to make Travis's life difficult, put him further back in the pack and stick Timmy out in front. Just a word about the Hansens. You know, what incredible tactics from them to go P1 and P2 today.
So you see contact. Travis hits Kevin.
You know what else, Jared?
He rose up.
The dust from the cleanup on the inside line. There's a lot of dust on the inside when we were cleaning up from transmission fluid and stuff on the track earlier on. So Travis, as Kevin's got into him, and then as he's jumped on the brakes, that, you know, the wheels are locked, the grip levels are different than they were earlier. It's rallycross.
It's a perfect storm. It's a perfect storm of, again, that solvent being down, Kevin getting in. It rose up Pastrana on the left side. He comes down, ends up on two again.
Cool.
And I thought it was over for Scott when he went into the Joker lap.
Yeah, you said he was on down a little bit ago, but I think he got hit on the way in, looking at the drone shot from a moment ago. So much. We've got to look at Timmy. Went so long on that jump. He's a weapon, Timmy is.
Yeah.
And so another win for him. That's his third Nitro Rallycross win. So we've had seven events, and that makes him the winningest driver in Nitro Rallycross, doesn't it? If you include 18 and 19, yeah. Correct. So that's his third Nitro Rallycross win. Yeah. So that's Travis, look. Coming in at the merge, in behind Scott. We knew that if he was in behind Scott, that he would take the title. That's all he had to do. It didn't actually matter where they were, other than if Timmy was further up the road. And I think that's what the Hansens are. Well, they're definitely smarter than us at spotting, Jared. And they dropped him in front of Kevin because they knew that would put a car between him and Scott. They were hoping, I'm guessing, that someone like Arpin would also have slotted in there. That might have given them the cars that they needed for Timmy to be able to take the title away. But the extra cars didn't come. Travis was exactly where he needed to be. He needed to be on the trunk of his teammate. If Scott was in front of him, he had a job to do. He got it done. They've won the manufacturer's title and their first ever driver's title in Rallycross.
Absolutely awesome.
Yeah, incredible performance from Subaru Motorsport USA.
Yeah, a great, like you said, first ever. And there it is. So Liza Markle giving him the trophy, saying, give the trophy, it's yours. And Travis takes it, and he earns it. Travis earned the championship of Nitro Rallycross. Nitro Rallycross Supercar, first ever champion. Let's throw it down to Will, who's down there with Timmy Hansen, our winner.
Timmy, let me face you around to the camera here. Congratulations, first and foremost, on that. That was about as perfectly executed for yourself and your brother as possible. What was the plan, and how well did it go for you both out there?
I guess we were coming into this championship fight in third place, and all we had to do was to win. Even better, take a first, second place, and then see how it all played out. We did the perfect weekend here. My car has been absolutely on point. Kevin did a fantastic race. I think he gave it up to me at that Joker merge. So, you know, this is just a huge team effort. We came through one and two, and it's a fantastic way to end the season. Of course, the Subaru guys did awesome. They have done all year, and they deserve the championship. So massive congrats to Travis, not just for today and wrapping it up, but for this whole year. He has been the one to beat at most races, and he has put this whole championship together. So I couldn't be happier for anyone.
Thank you so much, and congratulations again to both of you. Thank you.
Well said. Well said there by Timmy Hansen. Again, just you know, changing his tune a little bit from yesterday. And everybody wants to win, but there can only be one, either in the race or overall championship, accumulation of all those points. So as we're still going to keep on partying, don't go anywhere. Timmy Hansen did it, and there he is. Timmy Hansen, Kevin Hansen, Scott Speed, and with Travis Pastrana with that result, he is your champ. When we come back, the awards ceremony, don't go anywhere. We're going to continue partying like we did all year. Nitro Rallycross here at the Firm at North Florida. Again, come on back. Let's party.